Hello students, today we are going to discuss inverse of a square, means properties of inverse of a square matrix. What is inverse of a square matrix? See here, a square matrix capital A is said to be invertible. A square matrix capital A is said to be invertible. Then there exists another square matrix capital B such that AB equal to BA equal to identity matrix. Suppose matrix A order is n, means this identity matrix also order also n will come. So B is called inverse of A. Simply it is denoted by A inverse equal to B. So wherever B is there, in that place A inverse, if I replace A into A inverse equal to A inverse into A equal to identity matrix of order n. So this is the inverse of a square matrix definition. Now you observe. Suppose one matrix is there, capital A. If it is invertible means. It has only one inverse, unique inverse. So the inverse of a square matrix is always unique, means one and only one inverse exists if it is invertible. So invertible or not means one square matrix said to be invertible means it must be non-singular matrix. Suppose A is non-singular means we can calculate inverse, means inverse exists. What is that inverse means? Determinant of A into adjoint of A we have to calculate. So determinant of A is not equal to 0 means this is, it gives some finite numbers. In this matrix elements are some finite numbers. Suppose determinant of A equal to 0 means what is the A inverse? 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. Suppose this value 0 means it becomes an infinite number, so that inverse does not exist. So you remember, if A is singular matrix means inverse does not exist. So that point you have to remember. Next. Now you observe. What we have to prove? Suppose A is invertible means it has only one inverse is there. We have to prove. Just we are assuming that capital A has two inverses. That is A and that is B and C. So you observe, B is the inverse of A, C is also inverse of A. Just we are assuming B is the inverse of A means what I have to write according to definition of inverse of A square matrix? AB equal to BA equal to identity matrix. C is the inverse of A means we can write AC equal to CA equal to identity matrix. Now I am taking, suppose B equal to, can I write I into B also? B equal to I into B also we can write. So in this I value, in this place of I value, if I take AC, see here, if I take AC, so from this this is AC into B. AC or I will take CA. CA into B. These two I am taking. These two. So matrix multiplication is associative. So C into, we can write AB also. AB means identity matrix. So C into identity. So B equal to C. What we proved? Whatever we are assuming two inverses of A, B and C only, no. These two are equal means Whatever assumption inverses are equal means, so capital A has unique inverse. So that is the proof of one inverse exists means, one square matrix inverse exists means it should be unique. For any square matrix, if it is invertible means, it does not contain more than one inverse. Only it has unique inverse. So that point you have to remember. Next. Cancellation law. Left cancellation law, right cancellation law. Generally, suppose AB equal to AC is there. Sometimes B is not equal to C also, we can write. Matrix multiplication means cancellation law does not exist in matrix multiplication. Then when it is possible? If A is non-singular matrix means this is possible. How it is A is non-singular means A inverse exists. A inverse exists means just I am operating with A inverse on both sides. See, A inverse into AB equal to A inverse into AC. You observe matrix multiplication is associative. So A inverse into A, B, A inverse into A into C. A inverse A means identity matrix equal to B. A inverse A means identity matrix into C. So we can take B equal to C means left cancellation law means we can cancel AA. When we can cancel means if capital A is non-singular matrix means if capital A is invertible, then only we can cancel AA inverse. For example, see 2x equal to 2y is there. 2 we can cancel because 2 non-zero numbers only we have to cancel. Suppose this is 0 is there, 0 is there, so we cannot cancel these two numbers. So that non-zero numbers, if A is invertible means, then only we can cancel A. So that cancellation law under multiplication holds good when, if A is non-singular matrix, this is most important result you have to remember. Left cancellation law this is, right cancellation law means, you observe. Suppose BA equal to BA equal to CA. Same procedure. Right cancellation law holds good when if A is non-singular matrix. If A is singular matrix means left cancellation law or right cancellation law does not exist. So that point you have to remember. Next. This is the first property. Now, second property we are going to see. The inverse of a matrix is itself. Means, A is a non-singular matrix. Inverse exists. Inverse of whole inverse, nothing but itself. So A is invertible matrix. Let capital A be an invertible matrix. So A is invertible matrix means there exists another square matrix, and we can write A inverse equal to A inverse into A equal to identity matrix. You observe. What is the definition of inverse of A matrix means? Suppose AB equal to identity. Product of any two matrices is identity means these two matrices are invertible to each other. Invertible to each other means A inverse equal to B or B inverse equal to A. So that wherever B is there, A inverse if I replace means A inverse equal to identity. So instead of B, what is there? A inverse is there. So according to this condition, B inverse equal to A. So B inverse means that is A inverse whole inverse equal to A. So this is inverse of A square matrix, nothing but itself, that is A. So this is most important result you have to remember. Next, third property. What is the third property? If A is invertible, if capital A is invertible, then determinant of A inverse equal to determinant of A whole inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A. Most important one mark question. A is invertible matrix. A is invertible matrix means the determinant is not equal to 0. So now I am taking A is invertible means we can say A inverse equal to identity matrix. So taking determinant on both sides, determinant of A into A inverse equal to determinant of identity matrix. Already properties of determinants, determinant of A into B is there, determinant of A into determinant of B. At the same time, determinant of identity matrix is always 1. See here, determinant of A into B type. So determinant of A into determinant of B equal to identity matrix. So determinant of A inverse equal to 1 divided by determinant of A. So determinant of A inverse equal to, see here, determinant of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A, we prove. At the same time, this is to observe, 1 by x means, can you write x power minus 1? So this we can write determinant of A whole power minus 1 also we can write. So this is the result of determinant of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A or determinant of A whole inverse we have to write. So this is the third property. Next, fourth property. Fourth property. If A and B are invertible matrices, A and B are invertible square matrices. Invertible matrices means they must be square matrices only. Property number 4. So if capital A and B two invertible matrices, of the same order, then AB is also invertible and AB whole inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse we have to prove. See here, this is another important 3 marks question also they will ask. AB whole, prove that AB whole inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse like that. 3 marks question also they will ask. First you observe, what is the given data? A and B are invertible matrices. Means determinant of A is non-singular matrix, determinant of B is non-singular matrix. You remember, A and B are invertible matrices means they must be non-singular. If A and B are non-singular matrices means they must be invertible. So this is if and only if condition. Already last class we proved this theorem also. So you have to remember. Now what we have to prove? AB is also invertible. To prove AB is also invertible, it is enough to show that determinant of AB is not equal to 0. We have to prove. So for that purpose, we have to take determinant of A, B. According to properties of determinant, determinant of AB can be written as determinant of A into determinant of B. See here, determinant of A is not equal to 0. Determinant of B also not equal to 0. So the product of two non-zero numbers is also non-zero numbers. So we can write determinant of AB is not equal to 0. Therefore, AB is a non-singular matrix. AB is non-singular matrix means AB is invertible. So first what we have to do, it is invertible means AB whole inverse exists. First we have to prove whether AB whole inverse exists or not, we have to prove. Now AB whole inverse exists. If exists means what is AB whole inverse, we have to prove. See here. So just what I am taking, consider AB into B inverse A inverse. Another case, B inverse into A inverse into AB, I am taking. You observe here. Okay, first I will prove this one, later we will see this number. See here, matrix multiplication is associative. Means A into these two we can combine. So what I have to write, B into B inverse into A inverse. So A into B, B inverse nothing but identity matrix into A inverse. Identity into A inverse nothing but A inverse only. A inverse nothing but identity. So what we prove, AB into, so B inverse into A inverse equal to identity. How it is looking like? See here, AB is equal to identity matrix type. AB equal to, A into B equal to identity. So B is the inverse of A. So what we can write? A inverse equal to B. So from this we can write, AB whole inverse equal to, we can write B inverse into A inverse. Similarly, so A is said to be invertible means AB equal to BA equal to identity. Now reverse I will write. Now and so B inverse into A inverse into AB, I am taking AB. You observe, B inverse into A inverse into A, A inverse into A into B. So from this, B inverse into A inverse into A means identity matrix into B. So B inverse into identity matrix into B means B. B inverse into B means identity matrix. So from this we can say that B inverse into A inverse into AB equal to identity matrix. So we can say that AB whole inverse equal to, again we can say B inverse into A inverse. Why we can B inverse, AB whole inverse means, see, what is the condition, invertible matrix definition? AB equal to BA equal to identity. See, AB identity, BA identity. So B is the inverse of A. What is the B here? This one. This is A type. So A inverse equal to B type. Or A inverse equal to B type. So that is the, under definition only I written like this. So If you write first what you have to prove, AB is invertible means first case. Second case means first you have to take this one. Similarly, we have to prove this one. Therefore, AB whole inverse equal to B inverse into A inverse. So this is called reversal law means the reversal law and the reversal law of inverse of two matrices, product of two matrices. Similarly, three matrices if I take ABC whole inverse equal to C inverse into B inverse into A inverse. ABC whole inverse equal to C inverse into B inverse into A inverse. Suppose ABCD whole inverse is there. What we have right? Reversal we have right. D inverse into C inverse into B inverse into A inverse. So these formulas you have to remember. So this is a reversal law of inverse of product of two or more matrices. You have to remember this concept. Next. Property number 5. What is that property? You see here. If A is invertible matrix, then A transpose is also invertible. If A is invertible, then we have to show that A transpose is also invertible. Again, what we have to prove, and A transpose whole inverse equal to and A transpose whole inverse equal to A inverse whole transpose we have to write. See, A is invertible means A transpose is also invertible we have to prove. Listen, A is invertible means determinant of A is not equal to 0. To prove A transpose is also invertible means it is enough to show that A transpose is also non-singular matrix. Means now what I have to take? Determinant of A transpose. Already properties of determinants, determinant of A value, determinant of A transpose value, both are same. So determinant of A transpose is not equal, determinant of A is not equal to 0 means determinant of A transpose is also not equal to 0, because determinant of A value, determinant of A transpose, both are same. From this, A transpose is also invertible. So first case over. Second case, A transpose whole inverse equal to A inverse whole transpose we have to write. See, for that what I am taking, you see here, A transpose into A inverse whole transpose value I am taking. See here, A transpose, A inverse whole transpose, according to reversal of transpose of matrices, AB whole transpose equal to B transpose into A transpose. This is both, this is A transpose into B transpose type, or B transpose into A transpose. Then what I have to write? A inverse into A whole transpose we have to write. See here, A B whole transpose is there, B A whole inverse, B A whole transpose. See, A transpose into B transpose is there, this can be written as B A whole transpose. A transpose into B transpose equal to B A whole transpose. What is A inverse A? Because A is invertible means A into A inverse equal to A inverse into A nothing but identity matrix. So this is identity matrix whole transpose. What is the transpose of identity means itself? Now what we prove? This is A transpose into A inverse whole transpose means just how it is looking like A into B equal to identity matrix. So from this what we can say that B is the inverse of A, that is nothing but B equal to A inverse or A inverse equal to B. This is A B. So from this we can say that A transpose whole inverse equal to A inverse whole transpose. Most important result you have to remember. So A is invertible means its transpose is also invertible matrix. Then A transpose whole inverse equal to A inverse whole transpose, both are same. That is the concept you have to identify. Next, similarly, one based on this one only, I will tell you one more concept. AB one invertible matrix. Now you write this is property number 6 only. See, AB one invertible matrix, then we have to show that A power n whole inverse equal to, then see here, A to the power n whole inverse equal to, that is A inverse whole power n we have to prove. N means any positive integral power you can take. Now you observe. Now what I am taking, A to the power n means we can write A into A into A into A into A into and so on n times we have to write. So just taking inverse on both sides means A to the power n whole inverse equal to, what I have to write here, C. This is A into A into A into A into and so on A whole inverse. I told reversal of inverse of product of two or more matrices. What I have to write? A inverse into 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 A inverse. How many times? N terms are there. So that is A power A inverse whole power N. So what we prove now? A to the power N whole inverse equal to whole inverse equal to A inverse whole power N, where N is any positive integer you have to write. So this is another concept, most important property of inverse of a square matrix. See students, next property number 7. If A is invertible, so A is invertible means A is a non-singular matrix, means determinant of A is not equal to 0. Now we have to prove KA whole inverse equal to A inverse divided by K. K means any non-zero real number which cannot be 0. So which is not equal to lambda cannot be 0 at the same time real number. Okay. Now we have to prove KA whole inverse equal to A inverse divided by K. We have to prove. This is most important result you have to remember. So generally we are using property means A inverse formula. What I have to write? A inverse means 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A we have to write. So from this KA whole inverse equal to wherever A is there, KA I have to write. Means what I have to write, 1 by determinant of K, 1 by determinant of K A into, so that is adjoint of K A. So from this another result, what is another result? Result determinant of K A equal to K k power n into determinant of A means n is order of the matrix. At the same time, adjoint of k A equal to k to the power n minus 1 into adjoint of A. So this is 1 divided by k to the power n into determinant of A. Adjoint of k A means k to the power n minus 1 into adjoint of A. So k power n, this is k power minus 1, nothing but 1 by k. So this is, you observe. Then what I left here, 1 divided by determinant of A into adjoint of A. This one you observe, 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A means A inverse. So from this, this is denominator k, this total value A inverse. So, or you can write 1 by k into A inverse also you can write. So, this is most important result, k A whole inverse equal to A inverse divided by k. Similarly, minus A whole inverse means, if they ask means what you have to write, A inverse divided by minus 1. So nothing but minus A inverse you have to write. Similarly, determinant means 2A whole inverse, nothing but A inverse divided by 2 you have to write. So this is the another important property of inverse of a square matrix. Next, one more result, that is result number 8 we see. Result number 8. If A is invertible matrix, then we have to prove that adjoint of A inverse equal to here only I am taking A is, okay. If capital A is invertible matrix, then adjoint of A inverse equal to A by determinant of A we have to prove. Now for this to prove this condition, just I am taking, you observe, A into adjoint of A equal to determinant of A into IM, nothing but n is the order of the matrix. Just I am replacing A by A inverse. See here. Here A means A inverse. Then adjoint of, wherever A is there, A inverse we have to replace. This is determinant of A inverse, nothing but identity matrix. Just operating with A both sides, nothing but A into A inverse into adjoint of A inverse equal to determinant of A inverse, how to write? 1 by determinant of A, because what is the result? Determinant of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A. Sometimes to confuse, how they will ask, determinant of A inverse they will ask, you have to write. So determinant of A only we have to write. So in words sometimes they will ask, in sometimes symbols only they will ask, you don't confuse. Okay. A, this is 1 by determinant of A into, just we are multiplying with A only now. So A into identity matrix. A inverse nothing but identity matrix into adjoint of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into identity matrix nothing but A. I into adjoint of A inverse nothing but adjoint of A inverse equal to, what will left here? A by determinant of A, that is A divided by determinant of A. This is another important result. Adjoint of A inverse equal to A by determinant of A. So this point you have to remember. So these are the important properties based on inverse of a square matrix. One more important result. In CET purpose, you can remember this result. In CET or sometimes NDA, they will ask this type of questions. What is that question? What is the inverse of A diagonal matrix? What is the inverse of A diagonal matrix? You see. Suppose let A equal to one diagonal matrix I am taking, that is A1, A2, A3, means 3 by 3 matrix I am taking. So this is nothing but what I have to write: A1 0 0 0, A2 0 0 0, A3. Otherwise ABC you write better. ABC you have to write. This is ABC. Here also I am taking ABC only. This is ABC. So this inverse I have to calculate. What is how to inverse of a square matrix formula? A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A we have to calculate. So first the determinant of A. What is the determinant of A? Determinant of A equal to product of the principal diagonal elements, that is A, B, C. Then what is cofactor of A we have to calculate? You tell me. So first what I will write, this is plus minus, this is minus plus, then this is minus plus minus, this is plus minus plus C. Because A11, A12 we have to calculate cofactors. Instead of writing cofactors directly, we are putting plus minus like that. A into, you see, how to fill up this blank means first row, first column you have to delete, that is BC. This is BC. Then this is 0, 0. If you want, you can calculate. So, from this is BC. Next. Then this is 0. B means this is CA. This is 0. Already I told this column 0, 0. This is AB. So, finally, adjoint of A means this transpose. What is this transpose? Nothing but BC. 0 0 0 CA 0 0 0, this is AB. Therefore A inverse, what is A inverse formula? Therefore A inverse 1 by determinant of A ABC into adjoint of A, this is BC. 0 0 0 CA 0 0, this is AB. So divided by ABC means what will get? BC by ABC 1 by A. 1 by A nothing but A inverse 0, 0. B inverse 0, 0, 0. C inverse. So what is inverse of this diagonal matrix means? So A inverse into B inverse into C inverse. So directly option how they will ask means A inverse equal to this is diagonal matrix whose diagonal elements are A inverse, B inverse, C inverse, we have to write. Means product of two diagonal matrices is also diagonal matrix. So that point you have to remember. Next. Another some results you should know. Idempotent matrix is invertible. Its inverse is identity matrix. Its inverse is identity matrix. The inverse of idempotent matrix. What is idempotent? Idempotent A square equal to A. We have to calculate A inverse. Just operating with A inverse. So A inverse into A square equal to A inverse into A. You observe operation always one side only you have tried. This is left side means here also left side only you have tried. Suppose if you write like this, A into A inverse means this is the wrong process. In matrices you remember, operating A inverse or B, operating both sides means only left side or right side only we have to operate. Here left side, here right side means that process is wrong. So, here for this matrix left side A inverse operating means right side also, left side only you have to operate. So, this is A inverse into, this is what we can write, A square means A into A I have to write, A into A. A inverse A nothing but identity matrix. Matrix multiplication is associative. Means A inverse A into A nothing but identity. A inverse A means identity into A, that is identity. A into I into identity nothing but A means that is identity matrix. So what is A is identity matrix. What is A is identity matrix. So A inverse equal to A means A is identity matrix only we have to take. Now finally what they are asking question. This inverse will be identity matrix. This inverse will be identity matrix. What is the inverse of identity? See here. A square equal to A means A is identity matrix. What is inverse? See, what is inverse? Again operating with A inverse. So A inverse into A equal to A inverse into identity. A inverse into A means identity. A inverse equal to identity matrix. So idempotent matrix always invertible. That is also identity matrix. So its inverse is again identity matrix only. So inverse of idempotent matrix is identity matrix. So that point you have to remember. What is inverse of nilpotent matrix means? Zero matrix. Nilpotent matrix A power m equal to 0 is there. A power m equal to 0 means that is nilpotent matrix. Nilpotent matrix. Its inverse is also null matrix only you have to take. Then what is the inverse of orthogonal matrix? What is the inverse of orthogonal? What is orthogonal? A transpose A identity. Suppose these two I am taking. So what is that? A transpose equal to identity. So both sides I am operating with the A inverse. See, A inverse into A transpose equal to A inverse into identity matrix. So from this, matrix multiplication is associative. So from this, A inverse into A, that is A transpose, A inverse into identity matrix nothing but A inverse only. A inverse into I means, A means identity into A transpose, that is A inverse. So A transpose equal to A inverse means if A is orthogonal matrix means what is A inverse? A is orthogonal means what is A inverse? Nothing but A transpose only will come. So that is the another important point you have to remember. Involuntary matrix. What is involuntary matrix? Nothing but A square equal to identity matrix. Involuntary matrix. A square equal to identity matrix. So just operating with A inverse. So A inverse into A square equal to A inverse into identity. So from this A inverse into A into A. That is A inverse into identity means A inverse only. Matrix multiplication is associative. A inverse into A equal to A inverse. So A inverse into A means identity. That is A inverse. I into any matrix means A equal to, that is A inverse. See here. A is involuntary matrix means what is the A inverse? Nothing but itself. A is idempotent matrix means A inverse equal to identity matrix. A is nilpotent means A inverse equal to null matrix. A is orthogonal means A inverse equal to A transpose. So these formulas you should remember. Okay. So these are the properties of inverse of a square matrix. Okay. In the next class, we'll going to discuss some problems based on inverse of the matrices. Okay. Thank you.